Well, guys, there's so many things to talk about with this one. Hi, I'm Kitty with Atola Visuals. Let's not waste any more fucking time. I know I've teased you guys with the last two videos. Links down below if you're not caught up already. All right, main features of the Crane 2. Let's go. This big ass dial, the main features, ladies and gents. Here's what to expect. Let's throw on a telephoto lens, open it up to 1.8, which you could do on the handle, but we'll get to that shortly. First things first, turn on the gimbal before you turn on the camera. When you first connect the cable, make sure to select which camera brand you're shooting on in the settings. You can see Sony and Panasonic here as well. From here, you can also change the sensitivity of the follow focus. Here's some tests of each setting. Living for the nightlife, where you can shine brighter than all. And you dance in the late hours, I stand beside you to watch it all. And it used to be you and I, there's only one thing I recall. That I watched you fade, that I watched you fade. Field, especially because there's no tilt screen, it's really hard to nail a narrow point while moving. Thanks, Canon, for not including focus peaking. I suggest waiting for the dual handles to come out and putting an external monitor on it. So yes, the dual handles are coming out soon. You could also use the separate remote like you did with the Crane 1. I'm not exactly sure how to hold the gimbal and use the follow focus, but here's some options. Moving on to the other features. You could change the camera settings. Just click through and adjust in real time while using the dial. On the screen, you can also see everything else like battery level, what gimbal mode you're on, if the Bluetooth is on, whether you're recording or not, etc. You can also use the gimbal without even connecting the cables. The motors and modes work flawlessly. You can also go inverted and get 360 rotation. As we dive deeper into the settings, you can change the sensitivity of the motors. Since this has a payload of 7 pounds or 3,200 grams, you could throw any DSLR or mirrorless camera on here without even thinking twice. 7 days. I mean, 7 pounds. My favorite holiday is coming up, okay? Are you ready for Halloween? The people who are struggling with the Sony 24-70 lens on the Crane 1 will have no issues here. There's a little cradle to give your lens more support, which can be adjusted easily. I've seen a C200 on here, and you could even fit possibly an FS5, maybe an FS7, depending on what accessories you put on there. I would like to see someone test that out. Without the joystick, you could still move and adjust the tilt angle. They did this with the Rider M as well. Pretty cool, huh? Look at that. The DC8 power outlet allows you to take power from the three batteries with an 18-hour runtime. The cable doesn't look pretty, but it doesn't affect the strong motors at all. The features that are similar on all the other G1 cranes are the fact that you can connect the ZY Play app and control the gimbal remotely. You also have all the same gimbal modes as the other gimbals, however, you can see them now on this OLED screen. The joystick changed. Personally, I love the feel of the Crane version 2 the most. They also have it on the Smooth Q. Speaking of the version 2, the naming on this guy is a little confusing. You have the Crane 1 version 1 version 2, and now you have the Crane 2. I would have suggested naming it something like the Crane Pro or Crane Focus because of its payload increase and its major update on all the features. It's like an entire different level of gimbal at this point. You can expect the same quality as all their other products. This entire build is mostly metal, with the exception of the plastic dials, which makes it heavy but strong. And this handle is thick to fit all the features, and I mean thick, much like the Beholder gimbals. The quick plate is similar to the most common quick plates, which means you could take it off the gimbal and put it on a Manfrotto tripod easily. Speaking of tripods, I love that they included this mini tripod. I believe that they designed it to stay on to make it quick to pick up and set down. It doesn't get in the way, and it's the same metal material which blends in with the rest of the design nicely. The tripod has a 1/4-inch thread, but they provide a 3/8-inch thread adapter to fit it with the gimbal. A few issues with me was that the menu took a while to get used to. When you go into the settings and want to select an option, you have to click right instead of the center button. Not a big deal, but I did confuse the buttons a few times. In terms of who would use this, I see more of the professional crowd. People with heavier payloads who want access to all the controls on the stabilizer right there in front of them. So you got an entire camera crew right here. You got the AC, you got the camera op, you got the Steadicam operator, all in one package. So it'll save you money and hopefully make you more money in the future. Overall, I appreciate all the thought that went into this gimbal. The full controls, the ability to power on your camera, just seeing what the hell is going on with this OLED screen, the tripod, even the simpler things, like the ability to power down slowly so you don't smash your lens. And I never have to worry about getting a case because when you buy their products, they always provide a really good one. Even though they haven't got the Sony and Panasonic features dialed in yet, I applaud them for taking a step in the right direction. Just to think of the old school glide cams, and now one operator is able to control camera settings just off the stabilizer handle. Not only that, but it's also affordable. Pre-order down below. It's gonna be released early November. You know I'll be waiting for that Sony upgrade soon, Juan. So thanks for hanging out with me. Subscribe and like and all that glamorous shit. I'll see you when I see you, fam. Done. This strong motor, dup, 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 dup. Wow. I feel like I'm having strokes sometimes. My brain thinks too fast and my mouth can't catch up. ND filter. Boom. Moving on. It's got a thicker handle, and I mean thick. Fully controlled the gimbal.
Now you can't control the gimbal.